Wow, look at this tree. The leaves that are turning, the wind that's behind my back right now. I get to wear these sweaters again. This has got to be my favorite time of year. It's a season where we begin to think about the time that's coming. If you don't know what I mean, go into any store right now. You'll see that the stores are beginning to fill up with Santa Clauses and Christmas trees and reindeer and shelves upon shelves upon shelves with items that are going to be given away for gifts. They're going to go and they're going to be wrapped up and they're going to be put under trees. They're going to be there for a day of anticipation when we get and we give gifts. That's what this is all about. But we forget what it's all about because we get caught up in the idea of the commercialism behind it. The idea that we want to impress somebody. We want to make sure that our kids are happy or those that we love are happy. But see, here's the truth. God loved us so much. God wanted us to be happy. That God provided a way, a plan for us to return back to a relationship. See, when we come together at Christmas, it's all about relationships. It's about getting around the tree. It's about eating the meal together. See, this is what God wanted for us as well. So God gave us a gift. God reached out. He bridged the gap between our sinfulness, which separated us from God, to come back. So God has been reaching out to us since the beginning of time. Let me offer this to you in the book of John. See, it was the night that Nicodemus was looking for some truth, and Jesus met him in the middle of the night. And Jesus, after talking about what it meant to be born again, gave Nicodemus this about what God's love is. For only I, the Son of Man, have come to earth and will return to heaven again. As Moses lifted up the bronze snake on a pole in the wilderness, so I, the Son of Man, must be lifted up on a pole, so that everyone who believes in me will have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. God did not send his Son into the world to condemn it, but to save it. The truth is simple. God is reaching out. God is asking you to begin to accept that gift. What do you think? Next week we're going to talk about how we can reach back. I'm going to give you some answers of how we really can accept that gift that God is asking for us to receive. Let's pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, we thank you for your gift of your Son, Jesus Christ, who together you are bridging the gap. You are making a way for us, a way that we could never have gotten to on our own. We know that a bridge covers an area that is inaccessible by no other means. And you, through your gift of your Son, have been offering that to us. Now, give us the faith that we need to begin to accept these gifts. Amen. Hey, folks, I'm going to see you next week as we begin to talk about how you can receive that gift.